orbit beyond the blue.
In physical cosmology and astronomy, dark energy is an unknown form of energy that affects the universe on the largest scales. Emphasis on unknown. The proof of the existence of dark energy is supported by a number of observations. This includes the age of the universe compared to oldest stars, supernovae observations, and cosmic microwave background. There is so much we still don't know about space, but scientists looking at dark voids in the universe have revealed that it's these voids that could be causing dark energy. These voids are one of the largest features of the cosmos and can often measure in at hundreds of millions of light years wide. Some may even span several billions of light years in width, which is hard to get your head around. Many people often view these voids as holes in space and claim they are an example of truly empty space without stars, galaxies, plasma, gas, dust or black holes. Previous theories have highlighted that these cosmic voids are usually ginormous clouds of gas. However, according to a new paper, these cosmic voids could be the source of dark energy. And it's this energy which scientists say could be flinging the universe apart by causing it to expand faster and faster. The mysterious force causing the universe to act in this way is something that has been puzzling astrophysicists for years. Paul Sutter, an astrophysicist at SUNY Stony Brook University and the Flatiron Institute in New York City, explained what this new research means to life science. What do the voids have to do with dark energy? For one thing, the effects of accelerated expansion aren't felt inside of star systems or galaxies. There, the gravitational attraction of matter is more than strong enough to completely overwhelm it. For example, neither our own solar system or the Milky Way is getting bigger because of dark energy. But because the voids are almost completely empty, they feel the effects of dark energy far more readily. But now, in this new paper, researchers claim that dark energy isn't just found in the voids, but caused by them. They say that the enormous structures have grown over time. While billions of years ago matter in space was spread out pretty evenly, places that had a little more started to attract more matter into it. This continued until the accumulated matter formed galaxies, groups and clusters. However, this meant that these voids were being left empty and enlarging. Sutter explains, as voids grow, the walls of galaxies between them steadily thin out and eventually dissolve, allowing voids to merge. In the next few billion years, the voids will end up dissolving the cosmic web, forcing all matter into isolated clumps separated by hundreds of millions of light years of emptiness. As this happens, it leads to an accelerated expansion, which matches the estimates of dark energy. While more research needs to be carried out in this area to test this theory, it's certainly an interesting idea. Speaking of galaxies, there's growing evidence now that galaxies grow large by merging with other galaxies. Telescopes like the Hubble have captured dozens of interacting galaxies. Our own galaxy is on a collision course with its neighbor Andromeda. And it was while making these observations that astronomers stumbled upon something shocking. A few years ago, Geraint Lewis, a cosmologist from the University of Sydney, discovered that in the far outskirts of Andromeda were objects orbiting it. These objects showed signs that the galaxy hadn't been grazing, but it had feasted on large quantities of stars, entire galaxies, not just once, but in two distinct events. Yes, our nearest galactic neighbor ate its neighbors, again and again, something that led to the formation of a Delay structure. The Delay structure is formed from the leftovers of a massive feeding event and is a dark stream lit up by star clusters that are different from others in the Andromeda galaxy. This new information that has come to light is at odds with our previous karma theory, that galaxies merge to form bigger galaxies. the galaxy contains signatures of two major feeding events. The more recent of the two events took place sometime in the last 5 billion years, while the other one happened between 8 and 10 billion years ago. The clues that led to this revelation are the globular clusters. They are ancient collections of stars that have lower metallicity levels. Metallicity is the elemental makeup of stars, with elements that are heavier than hydrogen and helium being considered metals in astronomy. There are at least 150 of them in the Milky Way, likely more. They play a very important role in galactic evolution, but the role isn't clearly understood yet. Globulars, as they are known, are more prevalent in a galaxy's halo, while their counterparts, open clusters, are found in the galactic disks. Researchers have identified a population of globulars in Andromeda's inner halo that all have the same metallicity. But these globulars have a lower metallicity than the rest of the clusters within Andromeda, which means they came from elsewhere and not from Andromeda itself. It also means they are older, since there were fewer heavy elements in the early universe than there are at present. These globulars were named the Dulai structure, which means black stream in Welsh. The Dulai structure looks like the leftovers from a messy meal. It's a dark stream containing vibrant star clusters. The question remains, what was actually consumed? Because it doesn't look like it was just a thing, but instead a collection of things that were all slowly torn apart. When these feeding events occurred, the matter in the universe was very tightly concentrated. 10 billion years ago, there may have been more of these events throughout the universe. The history and evolution of the Andromeda is one that is important to astronomers. Not just because it can help us understand the past of our own Milky Way, but also because we are on a collision course with Andromeda. The two galaxies are about the same size, and hence a galactic feast seems unlikely in the nearby cosmic future. But that brings forth another question. Did our galaxy also feast on other smaller galaxies to guarantee its own growth? Since we are sitting inside the Milky Way, making observations about the galaxy is difficult, as they tend to be obscured. The distant Andromeda galaxy, on the other hand, offers a panoramic view for scientists. It is still not clear how the Milky Way fed itself, but evidence from Andromeda points to such large feeding events and growth. Telescopes such as the James Webb can aid us in the quest for answers about the Milky Way's past. In the next phase of the research, the astrophysicists hope to find out whether the Milky Way has done the same things as Andromeda, or if it is different in its ways, and also hope to come up with a more accurate timeline of Andromeda's feeding events. Hopefully, our galaxy isn't also one with a dark past, but what do I know?
Orbit. Beyond the blue.